come to our detective agency in a long time, but the rent bill is about to come due. A visitor! Finally! Would you be so kind as to open the door? I'll make some tea for our dear guest.
Good evening. My name is Jeffra. I'm an envoy representing the interests of the Vampire Nation. May I come in? I suppose I could let myself in, couldn't I have? See, like most vampires, I'm polite to a fault. Night and forest creatures have been enemies for a long time. Elves try to conceal the existence of the others, but vampires' thirst for blood was part of their nature, and eventually made them start attacking people unconsciously. Created a serum known as artificial blood. Its magic potion helped vampires to cope with their thirst, hide their fangs and claws, and walk in the sun. The serum reconciled the two races, and now vampires don't have to hide their essence. But Cornelius refused to divulge the potion recipe to ensure that the vampires kept their word not to secretly feed on living creatures. Cornelius opened the bar chain where vampires can quench their thirst. But last month, he disappeared. Without his serum, the vampire's claws have begun to grow again. Please, find Cornelius before it's too late.
Doesn't know Cornelius. He's quite famous among the others, and my family has a strong relationship with him. I know a bar where he likes to hang out. Could you call a cab while I get ready?
Thank you for listening. I'll see you later.
Sorry, the bar is currently closed for maintenance. Oh, I thought you were just an ordinary human. I'm so sorry. I have a little problem and, well, I think it's best if you just come in and see for yourself. Take the recipe from the table and make a faux blood cocktail. I still have a few ingredients left. Please, hurry up before you trash my bar. My magic isn't strong enough to suffering on its own, so hurry! Thanks for your help. I'm Luna, Cornelius's apprentice. I come from a long line of alchemists. I also know a lot about the fruits needed for vampire cocktails. What you see here is what happens when the thirst is unleashed. But since we invented artificial blood, the vampires have been able to enjoy the sunshine without fear. Since Cornelius disappeared, their ancestral instincts have begun to return, and they suffer from the light once again. Roderick is a regular guest of ours, and this is his first thirst attack. I don't want to see him suffer through more of them. Unfortunately, I no longer have a supply of Cornelius's secret magic serum. That serum is the most important part of the cocktails. I've heard about your successful investigations, so I'll try to help you in any way I can. Please, help us. is terrific! A clue like this could break the case. Surely there must be an address for the tower somewhere nearby. Take a look around, and once you find it, why don't you head straight there? We'll meet up later.
You can use my boat. It'll be faster. I haven't used it in a long time, though. Oh, before you go, take this. Maybe it'll come in handy later.
and his friends have stirred a vampire's artificial blood for long enough. Prepare to suffer as we have.
for your help. I am Valkyrie, the Elder of the Winged Ones. The blood of the Winged Ones is very nourishing, so I guess that vampire who attacked me was able to find me more easily. He must have been thirsty for a long time. I promised not to tell anyone about Cornelius's hideout. Cornelius has begun to receive threats from vampires lately, though he kept that to himself. He's safe now. I just heard that he made it to Wizard Park. All the elders are on their way there as we speak to hold an emergency summit on how to deal with the vampire issue. I can open a portal that leads directly to the park, but it takes two people to activate it. Perhaps you can help me with the preparations. And here, take this.
Thank you.
And then, just as soon as the vampires begin to trust him, he disappears. I can't wait to get my claws on Cornelius. If he stopped making the serum, I'll drink his blood instead. And you, if you're on his side, I'll kill you first.
Blight! His thirst is already at its limit. He is afraid of the light. Use it!
Yeah.
It's good that you dealt with that vampire. I was worried that war would become unavoidable.
Well, thank you, detective. You've been a great help. Without you, I would have never found Cornelius. Real bloodlust can only be quenched by blood. I have a gift for you, as I always hated elves. Take it.
It seems your friend somehow managed to survive. She's a lucky one. Greetings. My name is Mariska, the Countess of the local vampire clan of the Seers. I can appease Ymir's thirst, but in order for her not to turn into a vampire, you'll have to destroy Joffrey quickly. According to my subordinates, he is hidden in a dungeon beneath the city with a large contingent of thirsty vampires. One of my servants is currently waiting at the entrance to this dungeon and can help you get inside. My friend Peter has a map of the town with the dungeon marked on it. He owns the largest vampire library in the world, which is hidden on an island in the middle of the Waltham Forest Reservoir. You can use my helicopter to get to the library, but there is something wrong with it, so it hasn't been used in a while.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, I'm Peter. The rebel vampires found out that I have a map that marks the location of their hideout, so they raided my library. Fortunately, they never found the map. The vampire who broke into my office tried to torture me into giving up the map, but I managed to hold out until he beat me unconscious. Thank you for your help. I hid the map in the casket, but during the vampire attack, I threw it somewhere. No one but me can read the map, as it's encrypted. Please, help me find that map. It must be somewhere around here. While you're out here, I'll check my office. Where's the map? To get to the dungeon, use the vampire underground. It's marked on the map. But wait, only vampires are allowed to use it, so you should wear a disguise.
Hello. Unfortunately, I can't let you pass the turnstile without a ticket. But you can go to the free exhibition about the history of vampires. Can I help you find your way there? I appreciate your cooperation. The exhibition is right next to the underground. You can get to it by going up the escalator just over there.
My place is here, among the other starving ones. I will command this army, my army, in the war against the elves. Their thirst will give them the strength to prevail. And now you're caught in my trap. Remind me to snack on you after I defeat the elves, okay?
I tried to warn you that one of my men had defected and probably told Joffrey that we are coming here. But they captured me first, and put me here. At first, Joffrey wanted to kill me. But then he changed his mind, saying he could keep my clan out of the war with the elves by holding me hostage. I just overheard a conversation between Joffrey and some of his lieutenants, and it sounds like Joffrey's forces have already begun an offensive against the elven embassy.
Thank you.
Thank you for setting me free. Now we must hurry to the embassy to stop the vampires. Take this.
Detective, am I glad to see you. I got a message from Ymir. I'm her father, Lucius. She warned me about an impending vampire attack. And the elves almost managed to activate a special protective artifact called the Hourglass of Day and Night. With this artifact, we can literally change night into day. Since the vampires can't stand sunlight without the serum, they'll be forced to retreat, and the elves will be saved. We only need to flip the hourglass to make it work.
Greetings, stranger. It's been a long time since anyone came to see me. Don't you want to know a little bit about the history of the magical artifact?
I'm not interested in negotiating. Once you're dead, the elves will have no choice but to start a war.
thank you for helping me. But Joffrey is a powerful vampire. This won't hold him for long. By the way, I'm Anael, the elven envoy. I'll keep an eye on him while you look for a way to finish him off. Here, take this.
I just realized something. I saw that Jufra wasn't affected by the artifact. That must be because of the dome over the embassy. If you can find a way to open it, maybe we could finally defeat him. So, to keep the dome from being opened by strangers, one of the parts of the mechanism was hidden behind the vines. Take this diminishing potion. It will help you.
Thank you. It's finally over.
You made it! If you'd just taken a little longer, I would have become a vampire. Thank you for saving me once again.
It really all worked out. V.O.R won't hurt anyone anymore. Oh, how did I survive, you ask? I was saved by the ruler of the vampire race in exchange for your help in preventing another vampire war. Tell you what, detective, how about hiring me at your agency? I could be useful as a forensic scientist, since I can do any kind of chemical analysis. So, do we have a deal?